It is time for another edition of our history lessons with Dave Stubbs. And Dave is here in studio today. So, Dave, thanks for coming in. Columnist for NHL.com. You were in town for the big night at MSG on Sunday evening when the Rangers retired the number of Vic Hadfield. Give me your impressions of the evening.
How special is it, EJ, to reunite the gag line? Now you have Jean Rattel, who went up last year, Rod Gilbert, who went up long before that, and now Vic Hadfield is there as well. So the fact that you have these three guys all up together is very, very special. And Vic Hadfield, no matter how big and how brusque and how powerful and how bulletproof this man has seemed his whole life, he very much has been on the last, in the last year, he's been very much on edge of the, I guess, the emotional scale. He's been very concerned that he was going to lose it. He struggled a little bit last night, but it was very special for him to be joining his colleagues and his teammates and his dear friends.
Give the viewers a little bit of an idea of why that line was so special. Hadfield, Rattel, and Gilbert, as you say, the gag line, goal a game line from their era, late 60s, early 70s.
Yeah. Emil Francis originally had Camille Henry on the left wing with Jean Rattel and Rod Gilbert, and they were playing in Toronto one night. And Punchimlak, the coach of the Leafs, wasn't happy that his team was only up 2-1, so he sent out Eddie Shack. And Emil Francis.
And he was a well-known troublemaker.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, clear the track, here comes Shack, right?
That's right.
Eddie pretty much went out and destroyed, mopped the ice with these three guys. And Francis looks up and he says, the next thing I know, 30 seconds later, my three guys are lying on the ice. So he said on the flight home to New York, he said, this is never going to happen again. And he decided to put Vic Hadfield, who was really a grittier guy, a sandpaper guy, really not known as one of these goal scorers, put them on the line, and for some reason they just clicked, and they played together for about, what, 6-7 years at least, and that will never happen again. How do you put three guys together and let them build that kind of chemistry? So that's what did it for them.
And Hadfield was a guy, was one of, there's only a handful of guys that have scored 50 goals for the New York Rangers, so he was someone that fit in nicely there and became the goal scorer on that line, along with Rod Gilbert.
Yeah, the first guy, actually. Francis talked about being at practice one day early in the season that he scored 50, and he said Hadfield comes out with a curved stick, and he's got a stick that's like shaped like a banana. And he said, like, what are you doing, Vic? Like, I mean, you can't shoot the puck with a straight stick, no less a curve. And he said, well, I've been hanging out a little bit. You know, I have friends with Bobby Hull and Stan Mikita. So anyway, Francis says to him, look, the safest place for anyone to be in the rink when you are there is going to be standing in front of the net, because you're going to put the puck 30 rows up in the stands. Well, I think Vic was a little offended by that and goes out and scores 50. So Vic had the last laugh, and Emil was delighted. He laughs. He says, people call me a genius. He said, I put those three guys together for self-preservation because I didn't want to see my two skilled guys get killed.
Yeah, the cat, Emil Francis, he was the general manager, head coach of the New York Rangers for many, many years. He was there last night, so it's good to see the cat in good health and being able to attend the ceremony. You had a couple of photographs you brought with you, so give us the story behind these two photographs. Here's Vic with a very special hockey card.
That's a 1968 Opeachy card, and on the back of that card, they had a little cartoon, and on it, I guess it's two guys shaking hands, and one of them has a joy buzzer, and it says that Vic Hadfield leads the league in practical jokes.
Oh, okay.
Well, I bought that card for a few bucks in Montreal, brought it down, showed Vic. He got a great charge out of it. He said, geez, it looks like they just took the photograph today. He said, look at that good-looking guy in the card. And then we put the three guys together with the Budweiser Clydesdales. We're outside MSG, so we have Gilbert and Rattel and Hadfield all out together. And I know Vic well enough that I said, Vic, this might be the first time ever that you've been in a photograph that you are not the largest horses behind. And he got a kick out of that. So, I mean, Vic is very special, and it was a great evening, actually a great afternoon, a great evening. And I think that Vic is looking forward to getting home for a rest because, my God, the Rangers had him bouncing from pillar to post with public appearances, with horses, with human beings. But it was very special and a very emotional time for him, for sure.
And you noticed something now, because you have the greatest job in hockey, because you get to talk to all these guys for lengthy conversations with them. And you notice that the alumni, when they get together, It's they just kind of fall right back into it as if it had been no time at all, right?
EJ, you're absolutely right. It's like they've never been apart. I mean, these guys would have played, they would have been in the trenches together when they played in the National Hockey League. The family's getting a little smaller, sadly. I mean, nature takes its toll. Some of these guys were losing them. And those of us who are still around and get to see these guys, when you sit in a room with NHL alumni, you get a chance to really get a sense of how much these guys are plugged in together. The fun thing is that the stories really become embellished with age, and you know, the lies become massive lies. And in fact, a guy will start telling a story and a teammate will say, well, what are you talking about? You weren't even on the team then. He says, so what? It's a good story.
It's a good story. Who cares,
right? Yeah, good story is a good story. So that's been the very special thing about working with these guys, is the fact that you actually get to just listen and hang out and just be a sponge for their stories. And you're right, I will never deny I've got the greatest job going.
All right. Well, listen, thank you for the latest history lesson. We appreciate it.
Thanks, EJ.
Dave Stubbs, the great Dave Stubbs from NHL.com.